Dr. Rashmi Chawla, and in cost and management accounting, today we'll be dealing with the topic of advantages and the importance of cost accounting, the advantages in relation to management, the importance to creditors, employees, government, society, and many more. We'll also be discussing about the limitations of cost accounting. Now we discuss the various advantages and importance of cost accounting. The first one is how costing is an aid to management. See, costing provides invaluable aid to management. The various advantages derived by the management from a good system of costing are as follows. It provides detailed costing information to management to enable them to maintain effective control over stores and inventory to increase efficiency of the organization and to check wastage and losses. It facilitates delegation of responsibility for important tasks and rating of employees. For all these, the management requires a good costing system and using the information provided by the cost accounts in a proper way. So the first one, cost accounting helps in periods of trade depression and trade competition. In periods of trade depression, the organization cannot afford to have wastages which pass unchecked. The management must know areas where economies may be sought, waste eliminated, and efficiency increased. The organizations must wage a war not only for its survival but also continued growth. The management should know the actual cost of the products before embarking on the scheme of price reduction. Adequate system of costing facilitates this. Cost accounting also aids in price fixation. Although the law of supply and demand determines the price of the product, cost producer does play an important role. The producer can take necessary guidance from his costing records in case he is in a position to fix or change the price charged. Cost accounting helps in fixing prices. It provides detailed cost data of each product, both on the aggregate and unit basis, which enables fixation of selling price. Cost accounting provides information for the preparation of tenders, estimates, and quotations. Cost accounting helps in making estimates. Now, what does this say? Adequate costing requires provide reliable basis for making estimates and quoting tenders. Cost accounting helps in channelizing production on right lines. The proper costing information makes it possible for the management to distinguish between profitable and non-profitable activities. Profits can be maximized by concentrating on profitable operations and eliminating non-profitable ones. These were the four advantages which we did. We'll be discussing more advantages in the next slide. Now, the fifth advantage is cost accounting eliminates wastages. See, as cost accounting is concerned with the detailed breakup of costs, it is possible to check various forms of wastages or losses. Next, cost accounting makes comparisons possible. Proper maintenance of costing records provides various costing data for comparisons, which in turn helps the management in formulating future lines of action. Next, cost accounting provides data for periodical profit and loss account. Adequate costing records provide the management with such data as may be necessary for preparation of profit and loss account and balance sheet at such intervals as may be desired by the management. Next, cost accounting helps in determining and enhancing efficiency. See, losses due to wastage of materials, idle time of workers, poor supervision, etc. will be disclosed if the various operations involved in the production are studied carefully. Efficiency can be measured, cost controlled, and various steps can be taken to increase the efficiency. Next, cost accounting helps in inventory control. Cost accounting furnishes control which management requires in respect of stock of materials, work in progress, and finished goods. So, this was all about the advantages to the management. Now, next, we'll be discussing about the advantages. of cost accounting to creditors. It is also aiding employees and how cost accounting and costing is helping to the national economy. So the first one, costing as an aid to creditors. Investors, bankers, and other money lending institutions have a stake in the success of business concern and are therefore benefited immensely by the installation of an efficient system of costing. They can base their judgment about the profitability and future prospects of the enterprise on the costing records. Costing as an aid to the employees. Now, how is it helping the employees? Employees have a vital interest in the employer's enterprise in which they are employed. They are benefited by a number of ways by the installation of an efficient system of costing. They are benefited through continuous employment and higher remuneration by way of incentives, bonus plans, etc. Last, costing as an aid to national economy. An efficient system of costing brings prosperity to the business enterprise, which in turn brings prosperity to the business enterprise, which in turn brings the prosperity to the economy. It results in stepping up the government revenue. The overall economic development of a country takes place as a consequence of increase in the efficiency of production. Control of costs, elimination of wastages and inefficiencies led to the progress of the industry and in consequence of the nation as a whole. So these were the advantages of cost accounting. First we did about the management, then to the investors, bankers, creditors, employees and to the society and the national economy. Next we'll do, apart from giving advantage to a particular group of people, it has certain other advantages also, like it helps in costing, helps in decision making, it helps in providing vital information necessary for the decision making. For instance, cost accounting helps in deciding whether to make a product, buy a product, and second, whether to accept or reject an export order or a decision, how to utilize the scarce materials profitability. Then, formulation of future plans. Cost accounting is not a post-mortem of examination. It is a system of foresight. On the basis of past experience, it helps in the formulation of the definite future plans in quantitative terms. Budgets are prepared and they give direction to the enterprise. Then, avoidance of wastage. Cost accounting reveals the sources of losses or inefficiencies such as spoilage, leakage, pilferage, inadequate utilization of plants, etc. By appropriate control measures, these wastages can be avoided or minimized. Highlights causes. The exact cause of an increase or decrease in profit or loss can be found with the aid of cost accounting. For instance, it is possible for the management to know whether the profits have decreased due to an increase in labor cost or material cost or both. Then, reward to efficiency. Cost accounting introduces bonus plans and incentive wages systems to suit the needs of the organization. These plans and systems reward efficient workers and improve productivity as well as improve the morale of the workforce. Prevention of frauds. Cost accounting envisages sound systems of inventory control, budgetary control, and standard costing. Scope of manipulation and fraud is minimized. Then, improvement in profitability. Cost accounting reveals unprofitable products and activities. Management can drop those products and eliminate unprofitable activities. The resources released from unprofitable products can be used to improve the profitability of the business. Then, preparation of final accounts. Cost accounting provides for perpetual inventory system. It helps in the preparation of the interim profit and loss account and balance sheets without physical stock verification. Facilitates control. Control account. Cost accounting helps in control. It includes effective tools such as inventory control, budgetary control, and variance analysis. by adopting, then the management can notice the deviation from the plans. Remedial action can be taken quickly. That means we can compare the budgets and the actuals, and we can find out the variances, and remedial and corrective measures can be taken. So these were all the advantages and importance of cost accounting. But at the same time, we can say cost accounting not only has advantages, but there are certain limitations of cost accounting also. Now, what are these limitations? Number one, it is expensive. The installation and maintenance of cost accounting system requires resources such as analysis, allocation and absorption, and apportionment of overheads require considerable amount of clerical work. So, unless benefits accruing from cost accounting are more than the cost involved, it should not be sought. It is expensive. Second, different results from financial records. The results shown by the cost accounts generally differ from those shown by the financial accounts due to a number of reasons. Preparation of, see, reconciliation statements frequently is necessary to verify the accuracy. This leads to increase in the workload. So, there are different results of financial accounts and cost accounts, and that is why we prepare a reconciliation statement of financial and cost account. So, it increases the workload. Third, it is inapplicable. Why it is inapplicable? For lack of common. See, lack of common formats and system makes it inapplicable or impossible to apply cost accounting to all industries uniformly. So, consequently, the system needs to be adapted by the respective industry on the basis of the nature or the nature of the product. It is unnecessary. So what is this saying? It is unnecessary. Maintenance of cost records leads to duplication of work, that is preparation of financial accounts as well as cost accounts. Moreover, costing system itself does not control costs or improve efficiency. The management is alert and efficient. It can control costs without the aid of costing system. So it is not mandatory. System is complex. The system is complex. Cost accounting requires identification, categorization, and allocation of the different types of expenses, which is generally considered as complicated. Lack of accuracy. Use of notional costs such as standard cost, estimated cost, hampers the accuracy of the cost results. Next, use of secondary data. Cost accounting depends largely on the financial statements. The limitations and errors in the financial information directly affect the cost results. Next, cost accounting involves many forms and statements. So, what does this say? It involves usage of many forms and statements, which leads to increase of paperwork. Then costing may not be applicable in all types of industries. See, existing methods of cost accounting may not be applicable in all types of industries. So we can say cost accounting methods cannot be devised for all types of industries and services. Next, it is not an exact science like any other accounting system. It is not an exact science but an art, though developed through theories and practices. Biased judgments. Many judgments are biased and depend on individual discretion. Difference in opinion. Different views are held by different cost accounts about the items to be included in cost. 13. The next one, it is based on estimations. The costing system relies on predetermined data and therefore it is not reliable. Costing system estimates cost scientifically based on past and present situations and with suitable modifications for the future. This leads to accurate cost figures based on which management can initiate decisions. But for the predetermined cost, cost accounting also becomes another historical accounting. So this was all we did today. We did about the advantages and importance of cost accounting. At the same time, the subject itself is not free from the limitations. So we discussed about the disadvantages and limitations of cost accounting also. Thank you.